kilometers to the south of Chennai, right next to the well-known Center for Atomic Research in Kalpakkam, on the coast of Tamil Nadu, is India's big secret. A secret that scientists across the world would love to get their hands on. This top priority project, where Indian scientists have proved that they are far ahead of the world, is none other than India's fast breeder nuclear reactor. We are the first journalists ever to be allowed to enter the fast breeder reactor complex. And these are the first pictures ever of that enigmatic project that till now no cameras have ever recorded. It may look like just another construction site, but this is the foundation of the fast breeder reactor, slated to be the future of India's energy security, and maybe the future of world energy security. The prototype fast breeder reactor is set to do two things. India is very short of uranium, the fuel on which our current nuclear reactors run. But India has huge reserves of thorium, and the fast breeder reactor has the technology to convert this thorium into man-made uranium. India has so much thorium, it's been called the Saudi Arabia of the world for thorium. In fact, almost half of the world's thorium reserves can be found in the sands along our southern coastline. The second thing that the fast breeder reactor promises to do is produce up to 30% more plutonium than it burns, as part of the complex reaction in the reactor core, creating the heat from which electricity is generated. Plutonium is of course also used to create nuclear bombs, which is why the world's stockpile of plutonium is carefully monitored, and why the fast breeder reactor has been so controversial. But for the Department of Atomic Energy, this fast breeder is a peaceful project. The commercial demonstration of a technology pioneered by Indian scientists.
Energy security and strategic security, two phrases you've often heard being associated with the fast breeder reactor. The man in charge here, Mr. Prabhat Kumar, project director of the fast breeder reactor, says energy security is what is India's utmost concern in the future. Why is that?
It's obvious. Energy is the most important ingredient for safety and prosperity of the country. If you see, today we are depending very large extent on coal and oil. These are perishable. They are going to finish. India has an abundant amount of thorium. So we have to have a plan where uranium can be used very effectively, and then we can switch on to thorium so that we can provide required energy to our people for next 300 to 500 years. We are making one prototype fast breeder reactor, and at the same site it is planned to make two more fast breeder reactors. Then by in a year 2020, at least two more fast breeder reactors will come in the country. We have almost all equipment, all technology, everything has been developed in the country. The entire physics is done by country. The chemistry is handled in the country. The technology has been proven by making state-of-art equipment in the form of a mock-up model almost of the full size. And it has been proved that there is no issue associated with the construction of this reactor.
India is switching to fast breeder reactors in the second stage of its three-stage nuclear cycle. Till now, in the first stage, India has built and operated the more traditional light water and pressurized heavy water reactors that run on uranium fuel. A traditional nuclear reactor works like this. It uses uranium, or what is often called enriched uranium, to produce electricity. A neutron is fired at the uranium fuel, and fission takes place, which means the uranium splits into various byproducts, including plutonium. This fission reaction generates enormous heat, which, like any thermal power plant, is then converted into electricity. Hundreds of miles away at the Bhabha Atomic Complex in Mumbai, S.K. Jain, Chairman and Managing Director of Bhavani, the corporation for the fast breeder reactor, puts the prototype fast breeder into perspective.
Will we be in a position to
sell technology and fuel to the world.
Definitely. As far as technology is concerned, today India is the only country which has got mastery over what we call it as small and medium sized reactor. Say 220 megawatt and 540 megawatt reactor, they are not operational or they are not under, you know, design board of any of the country. But I am very confident 50 years from now, when the global scenario with regard to the energy availability will change, all those countries will look back with regard to the alternatives, and they would find that the fast breeder or the plutonium route is the only other alternative available, and then they will look at us and will be the, there will be reverse flow of the technology.
And the fuel, perhaps.
And the fuel.
Because we have,
definitely,
as you said,
definitely
the second largest reserve.
The thorium, the uranium-233, there's definitely a distinct possibility of even rather be becoming part of that.
The exporters of fuel.
That's right.
So how does this complex nuclear reactor really work? This is what the core of a fast breeder nuclear reactor looks like from above. Concentric rings of fuel subassemblies, 181 in all, swimming in a pool of very hot liquid sodium. Each of these fuel subassemblies is made up of 217 fuel bins. About a meter long and 6.6 millimeter in diameter, each bin contains a mixture of plutonium and uranium, which is used as fuel in the reactor core. When neutrons are used to bombard the nuclear fuel contained in these fuel bins, fission takes place. And with the breakup of each atom of nuclear fuel, three additional neutrons are given off, along with a great amount of energy in the form of heat. But it is critical to control the rate of release of neutrons in the reactor core. Without this, the reaction would lead to a catastrophe. And to control the number of neutrons, 12 control and safety rods are installed between the fuel subassemblies, which absorb the extra neutrons in the reactor core, thereby controlling the rate of the reaction.
Here at Ground Zero in Kalpakkam, the heart of a nuclear India, a reactor prestigious enough for India to stand up and be counted, a technology so fascinating, it looks like science fiction come alive. An engine that will produce more fuel than it consumes.
The fast breeder has a doubling time of 8 to 10 years, which basically means if it starts with 10 tons of plutonium, in the next 8 years it will generate another 10 tons of plutonium to start off another fast breeder reactor. The Americans know this and would love to get their hands on India's fast breeder technology. But when President George Bush came to India recently, India stood firm, and the technology will now remain out of world inspection and controls.
So in the long term, the objective is to come to a stage where we can really exploit the thorium technology on a commercial basis. On a laboratory scale, you may be knowing that it has been demonstrated that we can fabricate thorium bundles. They can be converted into a man-made fissile material of uranium-233, and a demonstration reactor is working. Kamini.
Okay, Kamini.
That's right, which actually uses the man-made fuel, right, which has been made by converting thorium into a fissile material. Right. It was very crucial for us that we must have a total freedom,
right,
to do these kind of experimentation, these kind of technological demonstration part. And all the scientists and engineers felt very strongly that in case this PFBR comes under the safeguard, it would involve that every such a step where even I have to remove even a single fuel pin,
right,
for the purpose of, you know, fine-tuning the technology,
right,
then the inspectors would be required to be present.
Right.
So that would have retarded our program in a very, very big way. Secondly, there are certain technological aspects which would definitely like to keep to ourselves. So we thought, you know, that intrusive safeguards,
right,
would also be retard the program, but will also be
give away what
the I would use the term the blunt the cutting edge,
right,
which we are trying to develop.
After it exploded its first nuclear bomb in 1974, India became a nuclear barrier, as trusted friends then, including America, boycotted and shunned the Department of Atomic Energy. was to prove a blessing in disguise. Without any help or exchange of ideas from the 45 nation nuclear suppliers group, Indian scientists were forced to work on their own. And they worked silently, but with a clear aim. The goal was to achieve an independent nuclear system that would no longer be dependent on the world, that India would no longer trust. India would produce a nuclear system that would fuel her growth far into the future.